Welcome to this new video, and in this video I'm going to show you another one of the features of VelociDrone 112, and in this case it's just a new scenery. It's not a huge feature like the previous one, our true lens feature. This is just a new scenery that we've added. I'm going to fly the Mode 2 Ghost here for this particular video. We go in here and the new scenery is called Large Car Park, and you can see kind of a preview of it up here, and we've got some tracks in here. There are some more tracks coming, but at the moment just got a couple of tracks in there. So I'm going to fly in here. I'm not going to fly with true lens activated because I want the full quality of the scenery to come through, and true lens would drop some quality away from the scene. Right, so let's just make sure we're on fantastic. There we go. Right, so this is the new large car park, and the reason for making this scenery was that the car park that we've got in VelociDrone at the moment is quite a big car park. It's got quite a lot of height to it, which makes it really quite easy to fly in there. It's not height restricted. It hasn't got all of these pillars and posts that are sort of in very close proximity, and as you can see I've already hit a few things in here, but this is really quite claustrophobic, this new car park. It's very, very low ceiling. Obviously you can fly very, very quickly in here. It's quite a big car park. I think it's around about 100 meters or so from one end to the other, so it's quite a large area. And it's got very, very low ceilings. The pillars are really quite close together. And what we wanted to create by having this scenery was we wanted to create a really closed in and very, very claustrophobic and really quite difficult environment to fly in, because that's what a real car park is like. You do crash into pillars like I just did, and in order to learn to fly in a car park, you need to kind of get used to this very, very fine throttle control. You've got to be really careful how quickly you fly, so you've got to control your speed, and you've really got to be on your game with the throttle so that you don't go up into the roof, because as soon as you do go up and you hit the roof or you hit a pillar or something like that, you then tend to bounce around all over the place. And bounce off every hard object in the car park, and you end up with fairly broken quad as a result. So with this scenery we wanted to create as you can see here, I've really bounced off that and ended up upside down. With this scenery we wanted to create that kind of really claustrophobic, really tight environment. And in fact, when I fly in here, I actually find flying in here is a little bit tighter than when I fly in a real multi-storey car park. It is really tight in here, and really causes me to have to really tighten up my flying in order to make it through here without crashing into stuff. So it's, if anything, it's a bit harder to fly in here than it is to fly in a multi-storey car park. It's a bit tighter, I would say, and of course the VelociDrone quads are quite high powered and quite quick, which also doesn't help, but it means that if you are able to fly in here and fly quickly in here, then if you were to go and fly in a multi-storey car park after getting good at this in VelociDrone, then you would find that actually the multi-storey car park is not as hard as you're expecting, because VelociDrone would have given you the capability to fly in a somewhat tighter environment than you're going to get in a real multi-storey car park. So that was the plan with this scenery, was to really, really sharpen the skills in terms of flying in a confined space, so that when you do come to fly in a real multi-storey car park, you actually think to yourself, actually, this is not too bad, I can do this, I'm not going to wreck my quad, because VelociDrone is just a, it's just a little bit harder to fly in here than it is in the real car park. It's just a little bit tighter, the quad's just a little bit quicker, and that makes it just that tiny bit more of a challenge. But that's a good thing, because when you come to fly your real quad in a car park like this, you're going to find it a little bit easier. So that was the idea of the scenery, and as you can see here, it's really quite a pretty scenery. This is in line with upgrading the graphics in VelociDrone. We've got our much prettier quads now, and we've also got much prettier scenes like this. If you compare this one to our previous car park, it's, you know, night and day difference in terms of the quality of the scene, the lovely reflections in the floor, and that sort of thing. And we intend to continue to keep doing that with other scenes. We want to up the graphical quality in VelociDrone. But I would add that we've done this without increasing the specification that you need in order to run VelociDrone. You will be able to run in here on a low specification machine. It's all been fully optimized to make sure that this will run quite happily on the low spec machines as well as on gaming machines. So no fear, it should all be fine. You should be able to run this. Okay, so I hope that's given you an overview of this new scene and what it's like. It's quite a big area across three levels, only a couple of cars in here to get in the way. Ooh, lucky one. Oh, and there are a couple of kind of hidden little bits, like this is the sort of thing that happens in a real car park, as you hit something and end up bouncing around. But you can fly through the pedestrian ways like that. There's like a little secret area that you can fly through. I'm sure someone will put a track together that ends up going through there. And similarly down here, there's another pedestrian entrance here. There we go, that you can fly through. It's quite nice. A bit easier to fly through than the pedestrian ways on the previous car park. So you can actually use them in this one. Okay, so that's it. That's the new scene. That's the rationale behind the new scene. And I hope to see some interesting tracks being built in here. We actually have some really interesting ones coming that will be part of the official tracks in the release, which I haven't added into this version that I'm showing you just yet, but we do have a couple of quite interesting tracks coming for in here. They're a little bit different to what I've just shown you. Okay, that's it, and I'll see you on the next video.